In this Dynamo for Civil 3D example, we're going to take a look at an existing script that's provided in Dynamo out of the box, but we're going to customize that to our specific project in our corridor. We can see here we have an alignment that extends well beyond the limits of our region or our corridor that we've built here. This corridor is just a simple highway model with walls on each side. We've got a fill wall on the right side and a cut wall on the left side. We want to create counterfort walls that go all the way down to the footing of this wall, but we only want to create it on the right side. In order to do that, we need to create some unique identifiers within the assembly itself. In order to do that, we'll go to the Home tab, and we'll open up our assembly catalog. Under the Generic tab, we want to mark a couple of points on this wall that are going to be unique to that so that our script can find those points. Now, when we look at this portion of the assembly, we can hover over those points and we can see we have an RW back at the top of our wall, and at the bottom of our wall we have an uncoded point that we'll want to provide some identifier for. On the left side of the wall we have similar points, RW back, and that's why we want to create a point that is unique to this point right here and right here. So let's do that with the mark point option. So when we select mark point, we can give this a name, and the name that we want to provide is RW for retaining wall back right. And we want to keep in mind what these points are because we're going to use those in our script. So we hover over that point and we'll right click to enter. And now when we hover over that point, we can see that we have identified that with the point that we need. We'll do the same thing on the bottom of the wall as well. Select mark point. And this time we'll call it retaining wall bottom right. And we'll select that point and right click and hit enter. And as we hover, we see that that's populated as well. We can now close our assembly library and we'll rebuild our corridor so that we have those feature lines incorporated in this particular region. Once that's done, we'll go to the Manage tab and we'll select Dynamo. Now our Dynamo window will come up and we have a couple of different examples that we can use in this set. We're going to select the second sample, which is our corridor counterfort wall. Once this opens, we're going to look at this and make a number of revisions to some of these blocks. First and foremost, it's pointing to a corridor called corridor-1. We've called our corridor eastbound corridor, so we want to make those changes. Again, this is case sensitive, so keep that in mind when you are providing values in your code blocks. And we'll go through and look at what this is doing. This is selecting this corridor and extracting a baseline. That baseline is then getting a start and end station, and it is progressing through the alignment. Right here in this code block, it's specifying that it's going to start at the begin station and go up 20 feet. It's going to go to the end station, but come back 20 feet, and it's going to progress 10 feet in between each of those. We're going to make this 15 feet, just to revise that. Now, as we look at the corridor feature lines that it's looking for, here is where we want to specify the names of the values that we provided. So this one was bottom right, and the top of the wall was called back right. Now, a couple things of note here is that this is looking at our entire alignment. It's going to look at the full baseline. We don't need to look at the full baseline. We just need to look at the region where our corridor was made. So we're going to actually go station by feature lines. But there's a couple of unique things that we need to do in order to make sure that this list functions properly. This transpose item happens prior to the corridor feature line coordinate system by station node, but we want to reverse a couple of these things. We're actually going to make this, we're not going to use levels for the stationing, and for the transpose, we want to actually make that just after this right here. And it may seem like a lot of our lines are crossed right now, but we'll get those straightened out in just a moment. One thing we want to do when we create our feature lines and use the stationing for those is we'll want to use our stationing based on those feature lines. So we'll go into Civil 3D, under our corridor, and our corridor feature lines. And we're going to select the start and end station nodes. Now, prior to doing that, we actually want to create a list that is using this single value. And so we need to flatten our list. We're going to select the list flatten command. And what this is going to do is just create and return a single value list that is compatible with the way that Dynamo functions for these values. We're going to plug that into our coordinate system there, as well as our begin and end stations. And now we can actually remove these, and we'll just simply select those and delete those. And now these are the values for our start station and our end station that will be returned for this script. Now this transpose list will plug into this coordinate system over here that is provided once the counterfor wall is generated. When we look at the geometry of the wall in Dynamo, when we have negative or positive values, those indicate direction. So positive values are going to the right and negative values are going to the left. Since we only want to create walls on the right side, we can ignore these left values that are drawn for the wall. And the only value that we need to take in return is this list that's created for these shapes that are drawn. We'll connect that one to where we place this and transform these shapes to create our solids along the baseline. So now as we view these values here, we can see that it is creating a surface that is lofting it and it's providing thickness to it. We can change some of these code block values if we want. Right here we've got the set at layer 0. I'm actually going to change that to structure wall. Once we have everything set, we have all of our nodes in order, we have our list flattened, and we are searching these particular codes by feature line, it looks like we're ready to run this. So let's go ahead and process this now. So as we look at the right side of our screen, we can see that some elements were drawn into there, but it does have a warning. So let's view what that warning is right now. As we hover over some of these warnings, we can see that it is telling us that our range is considered extra large. The reason why is because this particular project is drawn in state plane coordinates and our northing and easting values are very large. And so this is returning a value saying that some of these values are very large. We may want to consider revising our model size. We don't want to do anything to change this. Everything else looks like it's processed the way that we want to. So let's take a look and see what we've got. So we click in this window, we can see that we've drawn 20 feet from the beginning of our assembly, and it's ended 20 feet from the end. And our wall shapes go all the way to the base of this wall, and they're drawn 15 feet apart. And again, they're only drawn on the right side. So that concludes this example. This is to demonstrate that there are a number of different sample procedures that are included within Dynamo for Civil 3D out of the box, and these scripts can be customized and tailored to your specific project.